Hey, this is Josh Hewett from Top Form Fitness, and these are my training progressions for the one-leg pistol squat.
The first progression I'm going to show you today is the single-leg bench squat. Make sure that you're starting with a fairly high box or bench so that you can gradually progress the range of motion. Have to start standing close to the box, arms out in front for balance, extend one leg in front of you, and sit back. Keep your knee lined up as best as you can over the foot. This way, as you can see, I'm standing on a higher step. This increases my range as I squat down, but I still don't have to raise this leg up any further in front of me. Gives me a little bit more room to move, okay? So this is a good way to progress up without having to really crank your unsupported leg up. Okay, so as you can see, pressing through, squatting down. Keep your arms out in front of you for balance. Sit your hips back. Try and keep your knee as lined up as you can. Whew. And this way you can increase your range.
Keep your heel down and push from your whole foot. Make sure you perform equal repetitions on both legs. Okay, now onto the side box step up. As you can see here, I'm dorsiflexing my foot or keeping my toes pressed upwards, so only my heel can touch the ground on the leg that's stabilizing. Now, that prevents me from pushing off that opposite leg or using it excessively to help me do the step up with the working leg. Okay, to make this more challenging, we're going to increase the range of motion by either getting a higher step or elevating the step somehow. So I'm going to be using the same technique at this greater range of motion, gradually increasing my range and my stability in that bottom position until I can perform a full pistol. Okay, the next progression with the side step up is to perform it with a high box and not let your foot touch the ground. So as you can see here, I'm doing my best to get as low as I can without letting the heel touch. And that's significantly more challenging. The airborne lunge is performed balancing on one leg and then slowly lowering yourself back into a lunge position until the back knee lightly touches the ground. This is why I prefer to place a pad or a towel behind you to lightly touch your knee back onto.
At this point in your progressions, I suggest incorporating some assisted pistol squats. Here are a couple of examples using some straps to assist you in a full range pistol squat, or simply putting your knee and foot up against a door frame and using the edge of the door frame to assist you in performing the squat.
This next exercise is called a narrow stance squat. You're going to have your knees and your feet touching. So your legs are going to be next to each other, close to each other throughout the whole movement. Try not to let your knees come apart. Then you're going to squat down past parallel. Try to get your hips lower than your knees during this exercise.
Here are some challenging variations of an eccentric pistol squat. So basically, you're slowly controlling the negative portion of the pistol squat. On the left, you can see a more basic beginner progression, wherein you lower yourself down into the pistol squat and then allow yourself to roll back onto a mat. From there, you want to progress to be able to hold the bottom position. So perform a static hold in the bottom position of the pistol squat. At this point, you should be ready to progress towards an elevated pistol squat, which is basically a full pistol squat standing on a platform or step. This allows you to perform a full range of motion without needing to extend your leg in front of you as far. Focus on tightening the abs or crunching forward during the pistol squat. This will help you keep the leg out in front and maintain that forward posture. Once you've completed each of the previous progressions shown here, you should be ready to complete several full range repetitions on the pistol squat. Give it a shot, good luck, and stay strong.
So in this video, I want to talk about nutrient timing. Is there really a post-workout anabolic window?